Rachel Bach, and Alexa Bonna.
Teaching at West Allegheny, so we got a rookie on our hands. When asked what she by saying the people that surround her, meaning the students, teachers, custodians, aides, and administrators. She says that they made her first year extremely enjoyable. If she was not a teacher, she would be a personal trainer. We're going to start coming to you, Coach Paco isn't cutting it. Just kidding, please don't torture us tomorrow. In her free time, she likes hiking, being active with her dogs, skiing with her fiance, working out, traveling, trying any restaurant on Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives, watching HGTV, Modern Family, and Scandal. Her future goals include building her dream kitchen and bathroom on her own and having kids, hopefully geniuses or D1 athletes. Something that people would be surprised to know about her is that she was her conference player of the year in college and an All-American in basketball, but she's since then retired. Let's give all of our judges a round of applause.
It's time to meet our awesome contestants as they show off their formal wear and their lovely escorts. All the dresses were donated by Davis Bridal, and all the tuxes were donated by Men's Warehouse. Up first, we have Randall Alama and Emily Kiss. Brandon is wearing an all-black tux with that aqua turquoise vest. In honor of Brandon, he's having the best hair, I must say. His plans after high school include studying computer science at Youngstown State University. His zodiac sign is Pisces, and this Pisces is single and ready to mingle. Hey Brandon, I'm down to mingle. Brandon is being escorted by the lovely Emily Kiss. Emily is wearing a classy high-neck aqua turquoise dress with silver accents. Emily is a member of the National Honor Society, the president of Senior Chorus, the 2014 Homecoming Queen, and a high honor student. Her post-secondary plans are to attend Robert Morris University to major in accounting. Emily's interests include musical theater, singing, dancing, and softball. Before she dies, she wants to study abroad in France.
Next up, we have Dylan Lindemuth and Jenny Force. Dylan is the Vision of White, wearing a white jacket, white vest, and white pants. In honor of Dylan's, is having better hair than all the contestants. How do you feel about that, Brandon? His future plans are to major in music education at either Duquesne University or Robert Morris University. His zodiac sign is Gemini, and this Gemini is off the market. Sorry, ladies. Dylan is being escorted by the beautiful Jenny Force. Jenny is wearing a classic white dress with a neckline covered in gold. She is a member of the National Honor Society, a multiple-time state qualifier and Whitfield medalist in track, and a participant in the cheerleading worlds in Orlando, Florida. Her future plans are to attend a four-year university and major in athletic training. Jenny's interests include reading, competitive cheerleading, and track. Before she dies, she wants to go skydiving.
Now up is Brandon Rossi and Tara Savisky. Brandon is wearing a white jacket and pants with a golden vest. His plans after high school are to attend Robert Morris University to major in broadcast journalism. His zodiac sign is Sagittarius. Brandon is currently riding solo, so watch out, ladies. Brandon is being escorted by the stunning Tara Savisky. Tara is matching Brandon with a cascading white dress with golden accents. Tara is a member of the National Honor Society, a member of the Future Educators Club, a high honor student, a four-year letter winner in volleyball, an all-state player for junior and senior year, an all-Whitfield and all-conference player all 4 years, and captain for school and club volleyball for 3 years. Geez, Tara, you must be really bad at volleyball. Her future plans include attending Flagler College in St. Augustine, Florida, to play volleyball and study elementary and special education. Tara's hobbies are playing volleyball, dancing, shopping, eating, a lot, dogs, and working with children. Before she dies, she wants to swim with and kiss dolphins.
Next up, we have Clay Reem and Alyssa Formosa. Clay is wearing a light gray tux with a coral vest. Clay was on the 2014 prom and homecoming courts, and he claims to be the most wanhana person in the senior class. His post-secondary plans are to attend a four-year university to major in advertising with a minor in Spanish. Clay is a Sagittarius, but sadly, he's in a serious relationship with Chick-fil-A. Clay is being escorted by the gorgeous Alyssa Formosa. Alyssa is wearing a black cutout dress with nude netting. Alyssa is a member of the National Honor Society and in the future plans to attend Penn State University. In her free time, she enjoys spending time with her friends and her dog. Before she dies, she wants to be able to look back on her life and be proud of all that she has achieved.
Last but not least, we have Kyle McCracken and Jenna Van Dyne. Kyle is wearing an all-gray tux with a navy blue vest. Kyle is the captain of the soccer team and an all-section and all-woodfield player. His post-secondary plans are to attend a four-year university and major in international business. Kyle is a Cancer, but unfortunately this Cancer is taken. Kyle is being escorted by the ravishing Jenna Van Dyne. Jenna is showing off a navy gown covered in silver accents. Jenna is a member of the National Honor Society, a highest honor student all 4 years of high school, the captain of the soccer team, and an all-section player. Her future plans are to attend the University of Pittsburgh and major in pre-physical therapy. Jenna's hobbies include playing soccer, spending time with her friends, eating, and sleeping. Before she dies, she wants to bungee jump off the Golden Gate Bridge. Hey Jen, maybe you'll see Danny Tanner while you're at it?
That concludes our formal wear. Those boys sure do clean up nicely. Now that we've seen them all dressed up, let's see what talents these boys have in store for us. First up, we have Dylan Lindemuth taking on Thinking Out Loud by Ed Sheeran. Try to hold it together, ladies. Let's take a look at what he had to say in his interview.
Go Lex!
I first want to dedicate this song to my mom and the Argate.
Yes! When your legs don't work like they used to before, and I can't sweep you off of your feet, will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your cheek? Cause darling, I will be loving you till we're 70. And baby, my heart still fall as hard as 23. I'm thinking about
and I just wanna tell you I am. So honey, now
kiss me under the light of a thousand stars. Place your head on my beating heart. I'm thinking out loud. Maybe we found love right where we are.
When my hair's all gone and the memory fades, and I can't sweep you off of your feet. When my hands don't play the strings the same way, I know you will still love me the same. 'Cause darling, your soul could never grow old, it's evergreen. And baby, your smile's forever in.
Everybody is my friend because I go everything 100%, and I take no prisoners.
Alright. What is your favorite song to belt out alone in the car?
Uptown Funk definitely gets the juices flowing a little bit. You know, I'm getting ready for a big game, I put on some Uptown Funk. Gets me dancing in the car, get me psyched for a game.
Alright, I can relate to that. What is something people would be surprised to know about you?
I'm actually really quiet around school, and everybody always thinks that I look really mad, but really, like, that's just my normal face.
If you had to choose two celebrities to be your parents, who would they be?
I'm gonna have to go with Miley Cyrus and Will Ferrell as my celebrity duo.
And if you were to win Mr. West Day, what would your charity of choice be and why?
I would donate to Autism Speaks because I have a long history in my family with autism, and it would be nice to give back to autism and the autism community.
All right, sounds great. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
How's everyone doing tonight? Sounds good. So this act that I'm about to perform is for the senior class of 2015. It goes out to my mom. It goes out to my grandpa, Lou Martin. Thank you.
Wow, he's giving Ringo Starr a run for his money. Judges, what did you think?
Brandon, I think that was a great way to pay tribute to your grandfather. I mean, that was an awesome job, and I will make sure I never touch a drum set.
Right, I like the energy you brought there. That was some passion. That was a great job.
Tremendous work, but Miley Cyrus and Will Ferrell? Come on,
man.
Very nice work. Good job. Congratulations.
I'm going to piggyback off the passion part. However, I think I would have given you bonus points if you threw me one of your drumsticks.
I love the way you included everybody with the photos. Very nice job. The drumming was great.
Next up, we'll hear from Kyle as he attempts to serenade the audience with a John Mayer song. Let's see what he had to say in his interview.
Be good to your
daughters too. Oh, you see that skin? It's the same she's been standing in since the day she saw him walking away. Now she's left cleaning up the mess he made. So fathers, be good to your daughters, and daughters will love like you do. Girls become lovers, who turn into mothers. Mothers, be good to your daughters too. Boys, you can break. You find out how much they can take. Boys will be strong, boys soldier on. So fathers, be good to your daughters, and daughters will love like you too. Girls become lovers, who turn into mothers. Mothers, be good to your daughters too. Mothers, be good to your daughters too. Mothers, be good to your daughters, too.
Wow, he's a star on the soccer field and on the stage. I think John Mayer might be a little jealous. Let's see what the judges thought of his performance.
Although I was kind of looking forward to hearing Bohemian Rhapsody, because I would have joined you, I saw that you were a former Beadling player or current. I was a former player, so bonus points for that. Nice job.
Hey, you got me thinking about Baby Girl there. That was a good song. Cut deep there. Good job.
Yeah, I have to agree. If I was in this competition, I probably would sing the same song. But I think you did a little better than I did. That's why you're up there, man. Good job.
Nice work. Very good. Very nice job.
Thank you, judges. Now we will pause the show for a brief intermission. Take a trip to the lobby and take a look at our concessions. Remember that all proceeds go to the charity of the winner's choice. Song to belt out alone in the car.
Probably She Will Be Loved.
It's a nice song. What is your best cheesy pickup line?
Feel the shirt? It's boyfriend material.
If you were Mr. West Day, what would be your charity of choice and why?
I'd probably donate to Children's Hospital because your childhood years are your best years of your life and no children should spend that in a hospital.
All right, thank you, Brandon. Good luck.
Thank you.
Brandon, one word that comes to mind after that performance was just soulful.
Did he say soulful?
I'll need a wedding singer in about 18 months, so I'll keep you in mind. Nice job.
Thank you, judges. Next up, we have V. Clay Reed. If you know Clay, you know he's a huge fan of the movie Mean Girls. Whether you're familiar with the movie or not, you'll thoroughly enjoy this performance. Before we catch a glimpse of Santa's Little Helpers, let's take a look at Clay's interview.
I need it!
I don't really think I have competition because I'm perfect.
I think I agree with that statement. What is something you people would be surprised to know about you?
Well, I'm actually Beyonce's backup dancer. I'm in all her videos.
Oh my gosh, no way. I'm Jay-Z's backup dancer.
Oh my god, really?
Yes.
Let's do lunch.
Oh my god, my cool contact with people. And perfect. If you could have any superpower, what would it be and why?
I would turn anything into chicken nuggets because as you can see from this, chicken nuggets are great. He has 4 boxes, and I'm pretty jealous right now.
Yeah, I am too. Let's
get chicken nuggets when we get lunch.
Totally. Okay, ready? What is your best cheesy pickup line?
Well, I don't use pickup lines. My body speaks for itself.
I guess I have to agree with that. Choose 2 celebrities to be your parents.
I would probably pick Kanye West and Taylor Swift. That would be a really cool country
rock
music for,
yeah. I think it'd be pretty awesome, yeah. If you were to win Mr. West Day, what would your charity of choice be and why?
I'm gonna pick the Parkinson's Research Foundation because my grandfather suffers from Parkinson's, and that's just gonna be really cool.
That's awesome, that's awesome. I hope you win, good luck.
Thanks.
Judges, what do you have to say?
He's perfect.
one scale.
It takes a lot of guts to wear spandex in front of a lot of people. Secondly, did the kid eating chicken nuggets even go here?
The chicken nuggets did look amazing.
How did you select your dancers?
Well, they actually just were like, hey, we'll be in it. And I was like, okay.
Nice selection, very nice.
Thank you, judges. Are you going? Go ahead, I'm sorry.
I just said you did a lovely job.
Thank you.
Singing, playing the guitar, and playing basketball and golf. His favorite food is chicken, his favorite movie is Batman, and his favorite music artist is the Yvette Brothers. Dylan is part of a band called November Blue and is also a member of Show Choir. Something that people would be surprised to know about him is that he likes to sing opera. Dylan's favorite quote is, "True to Chains." Thank you, Dylan.
That concludes the cash aware portion. Now we will open the polls for Mr. Congeniality. Mr. Congeniality should show character, poise, and an outstanding personality. To vote for your favorite contestant, you should text their initials to the following. Get your phones out. 26940 West A.
26940972. Right there. Now we're in for a real treat. The dance group Jabberwockies decided to make an appearance here tonight. Sit back, relax, and enjoy this crazy performance.
Let's go!
have your mask on.
Woo, is it hot in here or is it, Lex, do you know who that was?
It's not hot in here, Rach. That was Danny Guilfoyle.
And Josh Barr.
And Zach Pendleton.
And Tyler Amador.
And Colin Wurst.
And Matt Starkman.
And AJ Patterson.
And Nick Weathorn.
Call me.
Let's bring out the contestants out for one final question.
Thank you.
finally, the results are in. Let's welcome our contestants back out, but first, a few thank yous. We'd like to thank the administration, custodial staff, NHS members, the contestants, the tech crew, the escorts, Men's Warehouse, David's Bridal, our judges and chaperones, Ms. Bernie and Ms. Barry. But last but not least, we want to give a special thank you to Dakota Lamb. He put so much time. Not only Mr. West Allegheny, but also everything else that goes on in the auditorium and more. 9 times out of 10, Dakota is guaranteed to be behind the scenes. Thank you for all the hard work and dedication. Contestants? Once again, Mr. Congeniality shows character, poise, and an outstanding personality. This year's Mr. Congeniality is... Clay Ream! Congratulations, Clay! All been waiting for. Can I get a drum roll, please? The 12th Mr. West Allegheny is, by 1 point, Dylan Lindenmuth. Drive home safely and have a great night.